Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video on the channel. It's going to be another podcast, The Celtic Mind. Today's episode, we're going to be talking about Celtic apparently make a bid for Ann Hickey. A bit more about Lee Griffiths and the story about when Lennon was in charge of him. Apparently he was fit. Glenn didn't, the rumours are all over that stuff. And apparently Lee Griffiths will be getting a new contract under Ange Postecoglou, and Ange Postecoglou, speaking of him, he has arrived in Glasgow, speaking of it today with Don McKay. Obviously Friday he obviously watched the Wembley to watch the England Scotland game, and he obviously flew up today. He is now in Glasgow. He'll take his first training session, pre-season training, tomorrow. But we're starting at the first point of the podcast, guys. Celtic apparently make a $3.5 million bid for Ann Hickey. Celtic have been linked with Ann Hickey for far too much throughout his young career already, and that's taken into account where we had him signed up twice and let him go twice. Hickey was a former Celtic Academy player but decided to go forge his path elsewhere to get noticed. Celtic have been obviously he's been linked to him. He went to Hearts, of course. The left back impressed with Hearts, as I said, and Celtic chasing him 2 seasons ago before the defender opted to move to Serie A with Bologna. Yeah, Bologna. A brave move for any young player. Today it's reported that Celtic have again come back for Ann Hickey and are offering $3.5 million to bring him back to Glasgow. Sports journalist God knows I am not out for him, so has claimed the club have made a bid on this on his social media. This is what the journalist has said. Celtic are interested in left fullback Ann Hickey, offered $3.5 million to Bologna. Hickey's a Celtic fan, he's talked to past about one day playing for Celtic. The time has never been right, and to be honest, if he stayed in our system, it would be like we lost it. He made the right decision at the time, but now if this bid is true, coming in for a decent money at a time where the left back position is up for grabs, could he be the one, you know? But we're going to move on now to Neil Lennon again. I thought we'd get rid of him. I thought we were going to be talking about him again, but we have, of course, the last video I spoke about him. It was making claims that Tenero was in an unhealthy obsession, and you know, it was just out with it. But Olivia, you know, I was just lining. I don't know what to say, man. It was just the last video I spoke about Lennon was 2 weeks ago on the channel, and that was obviously about the 10-year-old thing. He called an unhealthy session and a lot of things. Today he spoke to Jim White and Simon Jordan on TalkSport Radio on Tuesday morning. The former Celtic manager was in the makeshift studio with in Glasgow. The Irishman continues just the media taught himself what wrong with Celtic. Jim White branded Lennon fearless during the chat and declared that Neil loves a challenge. The response from the former Celtic manager was in keeping with the tone he had set since leaving the club. The response from the former Celtic manager, I said, Lennon said, I do like a challenge and I do say what I feel. Sometimes people don't like the truth. 10-year-old wasn't an unhealthy obsession. It was something that we were singing for plenty of years because we were brilliant. You know, why shouldn't we? You know, why shouldn't we push for more success at the club? You know what I mean? Why shouldn't we? He also goes on to say people want explanations, but then they turn to into, oh, he's making excuses, but I will say what I think and say what I see. I'm not worried about if it offends people. My conscience will clear that. We're clear on that. Neil Lennon has hired a media company to help change his image, so he can go down south and get a job. He's trying to big up his reputation while tarnishing his Celtic reputation. The former gaffer believes he says things that people don't like it somehow makes it an honest appraisal on the truth. That's not how it works, Neil. Sometimes you can say things people don't like and crux out there, position is what they've said is utterly untrue. Len had a lot to deal with in his final year, but he's had as much to blame as anything for the downfall of Celtic during the 2021 term. The lack of acceptance that he had a big part to play has rightly upset a lot of Celtic fans. Move on now to Lee Griffiths in a wee minute, but we'll talk about Ange Postecoglou as he touched down in Glasgow this afternoon, Wednesday, as his finals went out, and immediately made his way to Celtic train set in Lennox Town. The new Celtic manager flew in from London today after completing his period quarantine and wasted no time in getting down to work in person at Lennox Town. Postecoglou has already been preparing for the new season, having met with Chief Executive Don McKay last week in London. Now the Australian will be able to begin working with the squad and staff, although some of the Celtic players have not returned yet from international duty. They'll be driving home because, obviously, if you watched my match day vlog yesterday, disappointing for Scotland, but we got any Euros. But we can't just give up now. World Cup, we've got to go for it in September, definitely. He will be taking charge, take training for the first time tomorrow, June 24th, and will have 12 days working with the team before Celtic leave for the pre-season training camp in Wales on July 5th. Ange Postecoglou's first game in charge will be against Sheffield Wednesday on Wednesday, July 7th, and he will have a further 3 pre-season friendlies against Charlton Athletic, Bristol City and Preston. His first competitive game in charge will be against Danish side FC Midtjylland in the UEFA Champions League second round qualifying round at Celtic Park on Tuesday, July 20th. So I'm going to be keeping an eye, hopefully guys you are as well, keep an eye on Celtic, the official website today for the Celtic manager first interview for Lennox Town. That'll be interesting to see what he says about, you know, first team in the training and all that stuff. Interesting to see that. But yeah, Lee Griffiths is said, not said, but I've got into that wee bit in a minute, but apparently he's going to get a new contract from Ange Postecoglou. Postecoglou spoke to him and said he wants a, Lee Griffiths to play. Now, if you're talking, I mean, if Edouard's going to go, I don't know if he's going to go now because Leicester City couldn't agree personal terms with him. So, if you're talking, if Edouard does go, you've got a Yeti, and obviously if Griffiths signs, it'll be a Yeti and Griffiths. If that's going to be it, maybe, but we might want another striker. I mean, Lee Griffiths asked if he felt if he had not been given enough chances by former boss Neilan. He said, at times, yes. You'd have to ask the coach at Celtic or Lenny why they thought I wasn't fit. After the Scottish Cup final in December, I played 6 or 7 on the bounce. I messaged him. He's talking about Lenny. After he was let go, that I said, was one bad 45 minutes against St Mirren when we got beat at home. I had a bad 45 minutes, yeah, but I wasn't the only one. Then I wasn't seen again until the Falkirk game. I think about 2 months later, and that was the last game I started. You know, there's another point. I mean, Len is just, he's lost the plot, I think. He's just lost it. He's definitely lost it. But I think I'll leave it here, guys. But it's going in the right direction. You're talking Aaron Hickey getting apparent bids, Lee Griffiths apparently a new contract setting up, and Ange Postecoglou arriving in Glasgow today for his first training session. To take his first, to charge the first training session. So, guys, I'll leave it there, guys. That is the podcast. I'm pretty sure that is episode. It's been long since we've done one. So, 3 weeks ago since we last done one. It's episode 13, guys. Unlucky for some. Maybe lucky for Celtic as opposed to Postecoglou. Griffiths might apparently get a new contract and a partner bid for Aaron Hickey from Celtic, of course. And I'll leave you here, guys. Please subscribe and like. Recent views on the channel have been really good. Support is really good as well. And I'll see you guys very soon for another video. Peace.